You reach the end of the game to find an intriguing convergence of outrageous personalities. You are just dying to see what these heavyweights of batitude have to say to each other, but somehow you discover within yourself the superhuman restraint to hit pause. There is a whole world of fucking around going on with the meteor crew during the second year of their voyage, and it would be a criminal act of negligence to end this intermission without at least having a peek at their tomfoolery. A weaker person would just want to see what happens with Mennah and Vriska right away. Thank goodness you are a player with a strong sense of responsibility and discipline.
No, wait. More like, yeah, that's right. We are dropping it. Let's do this. We are, like, in the process right now. Dropping it like a Thanksgiving turkey. Tripped over something and shit just got away from me. My butterball's in free fall, motherfuckers. Look out, be goddamn low. Yeah. Yeah. Dropping everything today, making it rain, precipitating straight up. Mayhem. Hells of weather patterns closing in. Inanimate shit be slipping from my mitts. My digits can't commit to a legitimate grip. Wait. Nah, I'ma start over. Feel this flow out a little more. About how I'm dropping things today, just left and right. Things of all shapes, sizes, and dubious metaphorical merit. Things ain't even being held by chumps who can't be asked to show up. Dropping shit on your behalf. You name it. I'ma let it go. Drop it like a frivolous lawsuit. Oh snap, get out of my courtroom, bitch! Waste of taxpayer money, yo! Drop it like the most expensive fucking Christmas ornament. Step on that glass with your bare ass feet. Christmas is ruined, motherfucker. Drop it like the mug in Usual Suspects. Kobayashi was your cup, you dumb fuck. LMAO. Drop it like unemployment figures under the Obama administration's bold economic policies. Drop it like cargo on a space getaway. Just jettison that motherfucker. This rap is blasting off. Drop it like a bunch of firewood I just gathered. Gonna rub a couple motherfucking sticks together. Just sitting here whipping up sick lyrical friction. If you start smelling smoke, you caught a whiff of my diction. Shit's getting warm, but I won't stop till it's hot. Warm just don't cut it when shit's getting dropped. Tell me how you feel about shit getting dropped. How hot do you want it when I let go of the fire? Just say when. What? I can't hear you. I said say when, motherfuckers. Shit is burning my hands. F it. Here we go. Just drop that shit like a bad phone connection. I put gravity in charge of its downward direction. Unfettered to sense what it considers perfection. Shit thinks of the ground and it gets an erection. Best hope it's carpet bound in its downward spiral, cause linoleum's frowned upon, met with an eye roll. Landing on grass is just the course that it's par for, but hardwood fucking floor's what its wood's getting hard for. Guess I should mention instead of motherfucking hard-ons, how my motherfucking French could use a presidential pardon. Kick it, Barack! Here's where Obama's rap solo comes in. No, but how dope would that be? Oh, fuck me, that would own. Damn it! Rose, don't drink so loud. It's messing up my raps. I can actually hear your sips through my headphones.
Yeah, well, I can hear your rasp through your whispers. Whispers? Whipsers.
Oh my god. You are so fucking hammered. How strong did you even make that stuff?
It's pretty strong. Gash? Whoops, gash, gas.
Pretty strong. Rose, you just bootlegged some fucking rubbing alcohol.
I'll react much. I am completely in command of my facilities.
Faculty isn't a word, checkmate. This kind of strikes me as a sort of misappropriation of alchemy. Like, fucking with the mystical technology of creation just to whip up some moonshine just seems... I don't know, man. Tell me you at least alchemized a bathtub first to stir this shit in. At least that would be hilarious.
Oh my god, you're right! I missed a golden opportunity for a particularly humorous chaprosis endeavor.
And where the fuck is my apple juice, Rose? Gotta say, you really let me down on the AJ front.
I try making it. This was hard, Dave.
Bullshit, it was hard. What's so hard about apple juice? It's like the most basic goddamn juice. Like the square one of juice.
Yes, that's the point. Apples are startlingly vivical to reproduce. We take for granted our ability to take idealized instances of even quite complicated objects and conjure them from the void. But complexity implies a heavily recombinative nature. So many things are synthesized from a series of much simpler ideas. To those entities capable of conclusion and abstraction, an apple is as close to being a non-traditionally irreducible object as it gets. Notionally, disable. Tell me, hotshot, what ideas would you combine to make an apple? Exactly. Thus is why apples are such indivisible symbols when it comes to the field of ideas and their reductionistic essence. From the perspective of humans in particular, both from a standpoint of cultural and mythological significance, and from a practical one as well. If you happen to find yourself actually trying to engineer one, why do you think Adam and Eve were punished for buying into one? They attempted to penetrate an indivisible unit or fundamental knowledge to consume the interior of a thought which cannot be reduced any further. This knowledge was forbidden. So humanity was forever banished to live in sin and has strived ever since to redeem itself from the ruins of his intellectual foiling. Folly. Or what about the tale of Isaac Newton under the tree? He was bunked on the head by an apple. Not really an apple. Atomic idea. Elemental unit of imperfection itself. It clocked him right in the knot. And this individual notion colliding with his awareness, much like a high-speed particle fired to create a nuclear chain reaction, jarred from the void a more profound understanding of the intrinsic nature of nothingness. That is gravitation. Of course, these stories are actually bullshit. They didn't happen in reality, but the fact like the robot bullshit makes them more interesting. Men have crafted many stories that are bullshit as symbols risen from the abyss of consciousness without necessarily knowing what the fuck they're doing or saying as they flounder around for some truth. But despite themselves, they would for however briefly cross through a way of light, regardless. Because of the symbol state. The symbol holds off the power.
Well, shit. Looks like I wandered into a really weird, uncharted side of town tonight. It's called the Drunk Rose District. and I am scared out of my fucking mind.
For a guy who's supposedly, and I quote, so cool, you really are almost comically uptight. Here, why don't you have some?
No.
What a prune. Prune.
I told you I don't want any of your experimental fucking space wizard booze. I'd rather not go blind. Then Terezi will have to teach me to lick shit to see. Is that what you want? Do you want me licking everything in sight? Like, oh hey mayor, slurp. Oh fuck, you're not the mayor, you're my goddamn sister. Oh my god. You laughed way too hard at that, it wasn't anywhere close to that funny. I think you've had enough.
What?
Good lord. I still don't know why you were so bent on making this liquor. I thought you weren't really that down with the drinking. You never liked it when your mom drank, what happened to that?
Meh. She was a lonely single mom. I forgot for...
Okay, so why? Why tonight do you just decide to get completely wasted before you... Like... Are you nervous about your date with Kanaya? Is that it?
Is a date?
Yes.
How do you figure it's a date?
Rose, you are wearing a friggin' prom dress and nervously drinking your ass off while you are waiting for Kanaya to arrive. For a goddamn date.
Can't girls just look her best once in a while?
This is infuriating. Why do you even bother with this stupid charade? You could be at, like, a drive-in movie, making out with each other. All exchanging class rings while giving birth to each other's fucking children. And you would still be all coy like, is it a date or isn't it? Who can really say for sure?
Okay. Maybe I took a little sip to take the edge off?
Yeah. That turned out to be one hell of a sip. Maybe you should just reschedule.
No! No.
Just sleep it off, there are more hot dates where that came from.
It's cool, I'm cool. Really?
I'm just not sure you're gonna make the best impression like this. Come on, let's just find you a suitably soft pile of objects to sleep in before she... Ah, shit.
Hmm?
She's here.
Good evening.
Oh my fucking god, I can't even deal.
Oh. Hmm.
What is it?
Am I underdressed for the occasion?
No! You look so great!
If I'd known you wanted to dress in more elegant attire, I would have happily, Well, if, you think I'm fine like this, then okay.
Rose, I think you started drinking way too early. I think you just, like... completely fucking forgot to tell Kanaya you were dressing up.
Yeah, I... Wow, you're probably right. I started so... So... When did I start? What even time is it?
Man, you're gonna make her so uncomfortable all dolled up like that, not to mention three sheets to the fucking wind. This date is gonna be so awkward.
It's not a date!
Yeah, sure.
Rose, are you feeling alright?
Why do you ask? Because if you wanna know, I really felt quite fabulous.
Ah, it seems you may have imbibed one of your experimental human soporifics. Whoa. Yes, well then, I guess that would explain it.
Explain what?
The lethargy you possibly experienced when it came to completing our rendezvous in a timely manner.
Our... Wait... What?
I was waiting for you in the common area for a couple of hours, but you did not show up. So, I came to find you.
Shaking my head.
Oh. Oh! Oh my god! I forgot about our date!
Our date? Then you did intend for the plans we made to be a date. Which is to say, one that was romantically orientated.
Holy shit, we got a room full of smooth operators here tonight. Yes, Kanaya, it was going to be a romantically oriented date.
I'm so sorry.
But as you can see, Rose is hooched to the fucking max. So I think you're better off going out another time.
No! I said I was still up for it. I already fucked up by illusion track of time. I'm not gonna pull it again.
Ugh. You seriously still want to go through with this?
Well, I'm still amenable to an evening of whatever. But is there some reason why you would advise otherwise, Dave? I will have to plead ignorance on the subject of human courtship and its customs when it involves one or more intoxicated participants. Is there a problem?
A problem? I don't know, if you're cool with your date slurring words and making no damn sense about apples, then I guess not. Why are you both looking at me? Stop that. No, don't. Hey, I am not your fucking life coach here. If you want to go on a drunk date, what do I care? Man, what do I even know about human courtship anyway? Not like I ever dated a fucking human. So I guess have at it.
All right.
Awesome. Date night with drunkie it is. Go apeshit, I guess. So what should I do here? Do you want me to pack up my wraps and leave you alone, or?
Oh no, you don't have to do that. We can leave you to your slam poems in peace. Kayaya, why don't we go for a walk?
Yes, after you. If you can actually manage to... Whoa there! Maintain your balance. Okay, are you good? Okay, good. Let's go. Since it's now clear that your premeditated designs on this evening exceeded my own by a wide margin, insofar as you intended this to be a date with fancy clothes, whereas I showed up looking like something the Lucis dragged in, maybe now you can tell me exactly what you had in mind. I mean, as far as specific activities are concerned.
Nope.
Nope? I mean, nope. Nope what?
I honestly had not drafted the blueprints for the evening, aside from getting prettied up and actually, you know, being punctual about my commitment. Whoops.
It's really okay, though. I admit I was irked for a moment, but then realized it was so unlike you that extenuating circumstances were most likely in play. So I went to find you, and lo and behold, extenuation was what I found to be taking place.
OMG, Kanya. I'm so extenuated right now.
Honk.
Huh?
What?
Did you hear some?
No. Hear what?
Maybe you should turn the light on.
That better?
Yes.
What are we listening for?
Nothing, I guess. Anyway, I just thought that tonight we could just walk around for a while as we talk about really anything, like our worlds. Our future, or how you're going to save your species.
Yes, that sounds nice.
Just have a casual spontaneous evening. I don't see why Zazo have to always be a vulnerable fucking skill. Don't you agree?
Honk.
Huh? Kanaya. Can you keep a secret?
Yes.
I learned something earlier today. It was troubling. Something about Teresi and...
And what?
And Gamshi.
Huh?
See, I bumped into him earlier.
You did? Where?
No, no, please, please don't get angry and go on another vengeful cloud hunting expedition. This is the point. This is what's troubling me about this. I don't want anyone to fight.
Actually, there's no need to worry about that. I think I'm done trying to kill him.
You are?
Yeah. He has achieved victory through the gambit of coward's default. Don't get me wrong, he is still utterly awful. But sometimes, you just have to let a thing go, you know?
Yeah.
What were you saying about Terezi and Gamzee?
Right, well, apparently they are an item? Black ways, I mean.
What?
They are shades dating in the shadows. Nobody knows but me. And now you.
Are you serious?
Yeah. And it's been troubling me. The more I think about it. A lot.
Why?
Because it presents a prickly political situation. Terezi's relationship with Coghat is already somewhat tenacious with their, well, from what I've gathered about their history. And Dave, his involvement makes it even more complicated, and I think with Coghat being more else to Gamzee, if he finds out Gamzee spades with Tetrezi, then correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't that whole arrangement getting into territory of social taboo? Excuse me.
That could be very awkward, yes.
Right! I don't know if it's my sip powers, but I can see it unfolding all too clearly. Karkash finds out about it and flies in a rage. It ruins his ruins his diamonds with Gamzee, who therefore becomes less stable. And he vilifies Terpezi as well. And who knows how she reacts, or what happens with Dave for that matter. Would Dave actually be alright with Terezi dating a psychotic clown on the side? Even if it's a relationship centered around only enmity? I kind of doubt it. He would say what Cork had on the matter. Not even to speak of what your alignment is on the subject of Gamzee, which is whatever. I'm afraid that this could create a schism in our group that we could all be torn apart. And I don't want that. I want us all to stay friends and just be peaceful together.
Me too. I can see the dilemma here. Are you actually thinking about, doing something about this?
I don't know. Maybe I should interfere with the their hate dating. Maybe it's just a wonderful thing for them, and I would be horrible to interfere with their beautiful hate. The problem is, it's still so alien to me. The idea of black romance. I try to understand sometimes, like, more than, like, intellectually. I try to put myself in the shoes of feeling that, and it still doesn't make sense to me. I don't want to project my human values onto an alien relationship I disapprove of.
I understand, but what you're describing is... actually, I'm hesitant to even mention it.
No, what?
This is probably not a good idea.
Oh, please. You know you have to tell me now.
The feelings you are having are actually perfectly normal within the framework of our quadrant-based romantic tradition. I don't know if they can be felt naturally by humans, but the way you are viewing their relationship would be quite a standard response on Alternia.
Yeah?
Yes. It is sanctioned within the Ashen Quadrant, which addresses conciliatory romantic feelings, not directed at a single person, but at two people who are presently in such a contentious relationship.
Oh shit. I forgot about that. You're right!
It is generally not regarded as one of the more emotionally fulfilling quadrants to become involved in, and can be quite laborious to maintain, but it served a very important social purpose for my people, such as in situations very similar to the one you described, where two parties are highly drawn to each other through animosity. They may, in fact, be perfect for each other in that tumultuous quadrant, but to pursue the relationship would be chaos. Much like the scenario you laid out, the two Kismases, if left unchecked, would devastate all their other relationships, those in their own quadrants, and even those in other people's. So it is the job of an auspicious to make sure that doesn't happen.
Yes. Yes! Ganaya, that is exactly what I need to do!
Oh no, really?
Absolutely. I have never been so sure about anything. Well, maybe almost anything. But yes.
I don't think I would advise it. It's extremely difficult and can often feel like a thankless undertaking. In truth, it is probably the most challenging quadrant to master. Trust me.
I believe you. But I want to know. Can you teach me? There's so much I don't understand about your romance, but I'm so curious. I try to understand the concept of either constantaneous or platonic relationships as something that can be partially the emotions associated with romance, but it still doesn't really compute with me.
I really don't know if I would be a good teacher of auspicism. I honestly was not very good at it myself.
That's fine. Forget auspicious. Auspicious. Good dear. Forget specifically that right now. I want you to teach me everything.
Everything?
Yes.
That is a lot of things.
I want you to teach me all the quadrants. I want you to tell me about your spades, your didymans. I want you to share with me your clumps and your hurts. I want you.
And with the smitten seer's inebriated descent down a flight of escalation zigzags through the dark subway-like belly of the meteor, and with teen Xenolove mingling with weird honks wafting from the vent shafts to fill the fetid laboratory air with equal parts mirth and gaiety, we are ready to bid adieu to this vignette of hyper-important fucking around on the pitch-perfect note of a single textbook deployment of the rare yet highly embarrassing Drunk Happen X-Rose combo buff. And once again, we find ourselves poised to attempt to exit this intermission prematurely, while forgetting to address exactly no loose ends whatsoever. You turn the page to find a pair of green curtains that won't close, and you are fooled completely by them, as usual. And there you have it. Literally the worst psych out in Homestuck to date, hands down. But seriously, we still need to see what Mennah and Vriska have to say to each other. Proceed to the next page to find out how these twin titans of in-your-face delinquency react to each other's unique brands of reckless anti-hero chutzpah. Spoiler warning, do not open dialogue until fully loaded. You spend no less than 90 seconds staring at this fucking GIF image before you realize the actual flash animation is on the next page.
Girl, wanna join my army?
Oh, I see. It's the Patience wannabe. So you're the one raising this army. That's hilarious. Sorry, I can't join your dumb army. I'm busy pursuing a much more intelligent strategy.
Who the fuck you calling a wannabe? Lousy pants wearing smart mouth or Ronnie or ripoff? Now get in my army before I poke you up, biatch.
Not gonna happen. I am, however, looking for a large number of recruits to follow me on my treasure hunting expedition.
What?
I need an enormous mob of ghosts following me around to get that asshole's attention so he can wreck more empty space and help me find the treasure. You want in?
That makes no fucking sense at all. In enemy way, I don't recall giving anyone clearance for a whale-normous treasure hunt. As the rightful heiress, that sort of noise has to go through me, yo!
Wow, I had no idea the Patience twin was such a riot. At least I hope you were trying to be funny with that remark. John, Tavros, stop goofing off over there and come get a load of this chick.
Oh, what? It's you.
What am I actually getting a load of?
It's Blue Boy. I forgot about this dumb nerd.
Hey, what are you doing with that? No, please put the pokey thing down.
Hey, Blue Boy! Catch!
Oh, yes! Again?
Oh, no! You did not just fork vanish my alt-universe ex-boyfriend! No, you didn't!
Guess you could say I made him disappear.
Who do you think you are? Some sort of bad girl? Please, that's obviously my turf. But you clearly want to rumble, so who am I to deny you the beatdown you're angling for?
Angling? Hey, stick to spotter puns or whatever if you're gonna talk smack. Fish puns are my turf. Or I guess I mean surf?
Yeah, I don't really do puns, mainly because I'm not a lame wiggler. Anyway, you sure like to wave that trident around while running your mouth. I wonder if you had any intention of engaging in any actual combat? Guess it's up to me to get this party started, as usual. Watch and learn.
Aw, man, is this what we're doing now? Changing into our bullshit god rags?
Your move, punk.
But these jams are so ugly. Blah, fine, here goes nothing. I look like hell, all beige and shit. How can you even stand these grody-ass thief duds?
Wow, unreal. What a prima donna. Tavros, can you believe this girl? Hey, what are you doing? Stop fidgeting around. Are you looking for something?
Must find my precious.
I was thinking of modding my PJs to look a little snazza. What do you think of? This. Or this? Maybe? Wait, how about... Yeah?
Huh. Oh my god, will you stop? You don't like your gear, just do what I do. Take it to the next level. Check it.
The fuck? Come on, girl, I ain't got no dice or fancy pirate threads. This is my top shelf battle mode here. But I can call for backup. My homies can teach you to show your royalty a little respect.
Hey, what's going on here? I mean, are you fighting with my dancester? This is so counterproductive.
Original recipe circuit, quit your glubbing and go god tier already. There's a rumble going down in the hood.
Oh, fine. But I'm not participating in this fight.
Hey there, dorky teen Marquise. Nice of you to join us. Your friend seems to think she's the only one who can call for backup. As if I don't have god tier pals waiting in the wings too.
Huh? What is happening here? Wait. Is this a party? Oh goodness, I think it is. This is like a fun costume party for ghosts, isn't it? What's the occasion?
Nothing, Megiddo. Just a run-of-the-mill afterlife smackdown. You're on my team.
Oh, but I'm not doing any fighting.
Neither am I.
God damn it, Arania. Alright, we need some non-pacifist chumps on the scene. Pronto. Hey! Everyone in the ghost vicinity, get your tail over here. Shit's going down.
Yeah!
Woohoo! Oh yeah, girls! Heard you were starting a party over here.
No, it's not a party. It's...
I see someone has chosen to dress as a pirate for this party. In spite of the negative associations the old marauding classes have with violent abuse, oppression, not even to mention...
Dude, get the fuck out!
You poor him, nice costume! Way to change into something on such short notice! High five!
What? No, this isn't a costume. This is just what I was wearing. I came over here to see what all the commotion was about.
Damn, girl, you just looking fine for the hell of it then. Girl power!
Sure. So, this is a party? Sounds like fun.
No, it's not a party! God fucking damn it.
Let's annihilate them. Yes, let's. I'm in the mood to ruin somebody.
Right on! I knew I could count on you crazy metal broads for some mayhem.
Hey, Aradia, your robocones look like they're about to flip the fuck out. They're making me nervous. Can you try talking some sense into them?
Sorry, Selex. My robotic duplicates have always been free agents, totally exempt from my influence and better judgment. Equius. Do you think you can calm them down?
They are persnickety devices. Often sweat seeps into their circuitry and causes them to behave more erratically. Which, unfortunately, only causes me to sweat even more profusely, I am afraid.
Equius, we never talked about it, but I'm not sure how comfortable I am with you, courting such great plurality of my mechanical doubles.
On a scale of 1 to 100, how... depraved, would you say you find my behavior? Please be 100, please be 100.
I never should have kissed you that time. It was such a mistake.
I need a towel. A new one, I mean.
Have anyone seen my Hamlet? Hello, nice costume, buddy.
Be quiet. By saying anything, you're really making a horrible impression on people we should be trying to impress here.
I'm sorry.
I'll forgive you, but this is the last time I ever do. I'm at my wit's end with you.
I'm sorry, please, please forgive me again!
Glob! Whoops, I mean... Glob! Oh gosh, it's my ancestor! I'm so nervous, I can't let her notice me. She's so unbelievably cool. Ah, Tsunami.
Ah, snap, it's my ancestor. Wish I didn't notice her. Must suppress urge to murder her for royal supremacy, oh my god.
Well, man, could you maybe stop bumping me with your codpiece?
Sorry, Chief. Honest mistake. So are you doing anything later?
Wait, are you actually seriously hitting on me? Wow, dude. Even I think you're trash.
I'm a cool enough cat if you get to know me. You didn't ask for the question.
Fine. Let's go out on a date, I guess. Flippin' amazing, this tragic scenario's what I've been reduced to.
Hey, everyone stay on the right goddamn sides. Cronus, I'm looking at you.
Yeah, Nepeta, back in line. You people need to start taking this brawl more seriously.
Yo, my gangsters. Did I hear you going off to fight a ghost-killing demon? Mind if I tag along? I've been hoping for a chance to put an end to my cruel joke of existence. Bang right.
Hell yes! On this team, I have a major need for expendable people.
Horse Body Rufio, don't be such a downer! Didn't you get the Nyamo? This is not a cat fight, it's a costume party!
No, it really is a cat fight. A regular fight. Ugh.
Mulan, it would be great if you didn't use this party as a platform to engage in suicide shaming. I think Rufio is triggered enough as it is having to live with the heinous body of a metal horse.
Are you fuckers deaf? This ain't a party!
Horace, your outfit looks nice, but sorry to say it was a false alarm. It's not a costume party.
Oh, this isn't a costume. I am literally a majestic stallion, and my appearance reflects this noble reality.
Ah, gotcha. Hey, guys, can I be on the other team?
Yes!
No!
This gathering has completely blown away my ability to tolerate stupidity and awfulness! Get me the fuck out of here! God damn it! The crowd is getting too thick! I can't even get away from this shit! Everybody fucking move!
Excuse me, other people who are me and otherwise?
Honk!
Have you seen a beautiful treasure on the floor? That is more specifically a ring?
Carcat, shut up! This is great! We need to get more people jammed into this sweet fight party masquerade.
I saw the crowd from way over there. According to the people out on the cusp, this is some sort of costume party?
True facts, girl! Just jam yourself into the pile like this!
Ah, fuck. Are people all the way over there still calling this a party?
Destroy.
Someone is touching me! This needs to stop!
誰かが私に触れている。続けてください。
Someone is triggering me! This needs to be tagged!
Shush.
I'm sorry.
Oh god! I can hear him whining from all the way over there!
Someone over there is probably making the same observation about you.
Yeah, and your ancestor is probably chiding him maternally over there! Just like you are with me! Ever think about that?
I'm sorry. Kill.
Where? Where?
This party is a fucking joke.
No. It's a shitty battle royale. Pass it on, you dirt scraping sack of honey Dijon rubbish.
Nice dress, Finface. Halal.
Is my precious?
Tavros, stop crawling around under everyone's feet. You're being so weird.
Yeah, we can all hear you whispering to yourself. Pretty weird, bro.
None of them can understand.
Destroy.
Yo, I think I hear my young ancestor whispering from all the way over here about something precious. Shit is crazy.
The beauty of my precious.
It reminds me of when I was similarly smitten and searched everywhere for the perfect snout ring for you to fortify our commitment. Do you remember, Rufio?
Whoa, yeah. Hey, those were the days. Hey, doll. Mind if we talk a bit? I'm aiming to look distracted.
So the guy with the ponytail leaves me alone? You dig?
Death to all.
Damn. So much like the real thing, it's freaky.
Like what real thing?
You know, like...
If you say like a live Aradia, I will make you beg for a horse body.
No, like something else. Damn, uncanny.
Oh, okay.
Hey, you're pretty cool, babe. Wanna, like, if you aren't doing anything.
Excuse me, what is going on over here?
Man, not another zonk. This is fucking crazy.
This guy with the mohawk was flirting with me, and I was being fully receptive to his advances.
Whoa, you were?
I see. Aradiabot number 10502, why must you devastate my pump biscuit so?
The counselor astutely observes the exchange and updates her shipping grid with startling developments of the heart.
Nepeta, stop.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No!
Honk!
More. More, I say.
I found it! The ring!
Wow! That whisper was so loud, I think even I heard it!
No, wait. This isn't it.
Hey there, sport. I think that's my ring you have there. I've been looking all over for it.
Oh, okay. Here you go.
Thank you, friend. Thank you so very, very, very much.
Oh, wow. This hug is lasting.
Hey, skip to your Emporia! If you touch him again, I will fucking kill you!
Oh, woman!
Circuit Deuce, is this bullcart as aggravating to you as it is to me?
At least as much. Probably a lot more.
Like, seriously, it's so crowded now, our faces are literally touching. That can't be right.
I know, it's getting pretty awkward.
Let's back these asshats up and get on with our fight.
Agreed.
Listen to me, both of you! This duel is incredibly pointless. Surely there is a way for you both to pursue your objectives without conflict. In any case, I don't have time to moderate your ridiculous fight. I have a cherub to find.
I couldn't agree more. Making him think we're all looking for the cherub is a very important part of the plan. I guess great minds think alike.
No, but I really am looking for her.
All the better then. That'll really help sell the ruse.
It's not a ruse.
Classic Flavor Circuit is right, though. We are sort of wasting time here. Let's hurry this up and make it simple. If I win, then all these dorkwads join my army, including you. If you win, you get all the spoils and go hunt for the treasure.
And if luck should conspire to make it a draw?
I don't know, man. Then I guess we combine all our plans into one huge clusterfuck plan? Like, this whole thing ain't one big clusterfuck already.
I will agree to those terms. This is going to be almost too easy.
Circuit the sequel, shut your cocky mouth and fight me.
Stop, you guys!
Idiot bitches!
Wake up, sleepyhead.
End of Act 6, Intermission 3.